alcohol.
I see it daily.
And how about mental illness?
I'd say probably 65-70%. You know, you see a lot of people talking to themselves, you know, having full-blown conversations with a tree, a rock, just walking down the street, just screaming as loud as they can at, you know, imaginary people floating next to them, you know, pointing at something that nothing's there, trying to make a point or an issue with something and there's nothing there. And I feel sorry for those people, those individuals that can't get the medical help because they're, I forget what it's called, the medically indigent, you know, and I feel sorry for those people because they actually need the help. And that little forum they had at the VOA, you know, last week, that was a joke. It was smoke and mirrors, and that was all it was. There was not a forum to address any direct issue with the homeless whatsoever. Mine was a valid question that was not addressed. It wasn't dealt with. It was swept aside, swept under the rug, and I was pushed off.
So if you had an opportunity to tell Kevin Johnson and Heather Fargo something, what would you want to tell the leaders of your city?
Don't throw out there a bunch of words of what you're going to do. You're the mayor. You know, Fargo is the mayor. You know, forget about, you know, the incumbent, you know, Johnson or whatever. You're the mayor. Step up, come to the plate, you know, take a big swing, aim for the fences. You know, if you're going to either, you're going to strike out or you're going to smack one out of the ballpark. Go for it. Don't talk about it. Do it. You're the mayor of Sacramento. Do it. Put your money where your mouth is.
Take some action.
Exactly. Don't talk about it. Don't go through the media. Don't go through, you know, the papers. Don't have these forums, this and that, these, you know, town hall meetings. It's a waste of time.
What kind of action do you see would be the most helpful?
Where do I start? The biggest thing is getting people off the street. You know, the number one thing is getting, they want to keep shuffling people away from wherever they're comfortable. Where we're at, we're comfortable, we're situated, but speaking to the Rangers, they said that the police are going to come through, they're going to sweep, and they're going to make us leave. Well, we're comfortable here, you know, we're stable, we're situated, I'm able to shower, shave, you know, we can go do our laundry, I'm able to go to work and still look for work.
What do you mean you have place to shower and shave? Where does that happen?
We purchased a portable shower that we're able to use. Shave.
So what other specific things? I'd like to hear some specific ideas directly besides getting people off the street that you could, if you could say to Mayor Fargo, how she could directly help the homeless.
Job-related programs. I looked into the adult education over on Lemon Hill. Drop the fees, you know, for these classes to help people get licenses. There's the culinary, you know, field. There was the court reporting. There's stenography. You know, they were talking about, you know, stenographers start out making $65,000 a year. You know, place these individuals in these programs and cover the cost. If you're homeless, you don't have $700, $800, $900, $1,200 to drop down on these courses and these classes. You know, there's Pell grants that assist to a point. Pick up the balance for these people. The Pell grants will pay this as long as you carry a B average in your class. Let the county or city pick up the remaining balance. But you got to be in class. You got to carry your grades. You got to do the footwork. If I was Fargo or Johnson, but mainly Fargo since she's still the mayor, if we're going to help you do this, you better carry a B average. Period. If you don't do it, don't talk to me about you've got kids. You need daycare, you need transportation, we'll give you bus passes. Here's RT. You need to be in class at X amount of time, you get your children or whatever to your daycare, and you get up early. You gotta be there at 8, get up at 4, get up at 3. Get up, get your kids ready, my grandmother did this when I was a child with my two older brothers. Every night before we got up to go to school, when we lived in Chicago and back east, you know, clothes are laid out every night before we went to bed, so you're not fumbling around trying to get what you're going to get. you know, the next morning, get dressed, get up, brush your teeth, bathe, get dressed, come down for breakfast, you do your homework, when you get home from school, have everything done before you go out and play. Period. That's what the American family did.
This land is your land, and this land is my land. From California to the New York Island, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters, this land was made for you and me. As I went a-walking that ribbon of highway, and I saw above me that endless skyway, I saw below me that golden valley. This land was made for you and me. And rambled and I followed my footsteps to the sparkling sands of her diamond deserts. All around me a voice was a sounding, this land was made for you and me. There was a big high wall there that tried to stop me. A sign was painted, said private property. But on the backside, it didn't say nothing. This land was made for you and me. When the sun comes shining, then I was strolling, and the wheat fields waving, and the dust cloud rolling. A voice was chanting as the fog was lifting. This land was made for you and me. This land is your land, and this land is my land. From California to the New York Island, from Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters, this land was made for you and me.
Who the hell is Mayor Fargo?
The mayor of the city.
Listen, Mayor Fargo had her term, and this is what the result is.